Hello everyone, welcome to a new series of video on a new course known as Financial Reporting. We will discuss about the financial statement analysis in the first module, where there are different tools or techniques for financial reporting. The tools and techniques are used for the financial statement analysis and to draw conclusions and interpretations from the calculation and preparation of the statements. One such tool is the common size statement. We have another statements like comparative statement, trend percentage analysis, ratio analysis, statement of cash flow, etc. to analyze the financial statements and draw conclusions. So in today's video, we will discuss about common size balance sheet. So in common size statement, we have common size balance sheet as well as common size statement of profit and loss. So today we will discuss about common size balance sheet. So as you know, the common size statements or common size statement analysis comes under the category of vertical analysis. That means the figures of a single year are compared with the total of something. So in the case of common size balance sheet, each absolute amount given in the balance sheet is compared with the total of the balance sheet. That means either the total of asset or the total of liability. Say for example, the total of the balance sheet is rupees 10,000 and the absolute figure of current asset is rupees 500. So in the case of common size balance sheet, we calculate the percentage or the ratio as 500 divided by 10,000 into 100. So in the case of common size balance sheet, each item in the balance sheet is taken as a ratio of the total of balance sheet. So it is expressed as the ratio of each asset to total assets, and the ratio of each liability is expressed as a ratio of total liability. In the next slide, we will see the format for the common size balance sheet, and after that we will solve a problem and we will discuss it in detail, including the interpretation and conclusion from the analysis. So here we have the format for the balance sheet, and in the case of common size balance sheet, say for example, if we have 2 years given in the question, like 2017 and 2018, normally in the questions only 1 year will be given, but suppose in a question 2 years are given, we will prepare the statement in this manner. We will have the particulars column where we write each item in the balance sheet. We'll have the absolute amount column where we'll enter the previous year amount as well as the current year amount. Then we'll calculate the percentage of previous year and also the percentage of current year. So we calculate the percentage, say for example, the percentage of equity share capital as the amount of equity share capital divided by the total amount of liabilities into 100. Such that the total column always will be marked as 100% because it is taken as the base. Okay. So now we have a question here. The following data is related to Cambridge Limited. We are required to prepare a common size balance sheet. A very simple problem. So we have the details of 2018 as well as 2019. We have different items given: equity share capital, preference share capital, reserves in surplus, non-current liabilities, current liabilities, non-current assets, and current assets. So based upon this information, we have to prepare a common size balance sheet. Okay. So now we have the Cambridge Limited common size balance sheet as at 31st March 2018 and 19. Okay, so before preparing, please bring to your mind the format for balance sheet which we discussed already. So we have equity and liabilities as the first heading, Under that, we have the shareholders' fund. We have share capital. So in this particular share capital, we include equity share capital as well as preference share capital. So we have equity and we have preference share capital. Okay. So we write the first item, share capital. We write the amount. In 2018, it was 16 plus 2, that is 18. And 2019 also, it was 16 plus 2. Then how to calculate the percentage? So before calculating the percentage, we have to take the total of the liabilities. We have to take total of liabilities. So in 2018, the total of liabilities amounts to 40%. And in 2019, the total amounts to 45. It's not percent, 40 lakh and 45 lakh. Okay. So now we'll take the percentage of share capital in 2018. The percentage will be calculated as 18 divided by 40 into 100. 18 divided by 40 into 100. That means the amount of each item in the balance sheet or each item in the liability divided by the total of liabilities into 100. We'll get the percentage as 45. So in 2019 also, the total amount is 45. The total of liability is 45. So 18 divided by 45 into 100 will reach at a 40%. Okay, so I hope this is clear for you. This is very simple to understand. Now we'll go to the next item. Next item we have in the question is reserves and surplus. We have reserves and surplus. So next item to be written in the balance sheet as per the format is reserves and surplus. We have 4 in 2018 and 5.4 in 2019. So we'll calculate the percentage as 4 divided by 40 into 100 and 5.4 divided by 45 into 100. We get 10% and 12%. Okay. Then as per the format, we have the non-current liabilities first and then we write the current liabilities. So we have the non-current liabilities as 35% and 32%. Current liabilities as 10 and 16%. Okay. And the total, we have 40, 45 and 100% each. So I hope that is clear for you regarding the liabilities. Same mechanism we follow in the case of assets also. So first we'll take the total of assets. Total of assets in 2019 it is 30.60 plus 14.4 and in 2018 it is 28 plus 12. So 2018 it will be 40 and 2019 it will be 45, same as that of the total of liabilities. Okay, so now we'll go to the asset side. First we write non-current asset, then we have current asset. Non-current asset will calculate the percentages 28 divided by 40 into 100 will get 70% and 30.6 divided by 45 will get 68%. Same as that of current assets. We calculate current asset percentage also in the same manner. So just remember, we take each item from the liability side and divide it with the total of liabilities and find the percentage. In the same manner, we take each component of asset side divided by the total of assets and then we'll find the percentage. Okay. So before winding up, let us interpret this particular analysis. What does this analysis mean? So after each analysis or after each calculation of this percentage, we have to write an interpretation or conclusion from this analysis. So from the above solution or from the above problem, balance, common sense balance sheet, it is evident that even though the share capital amount was same for 2018 and 2019, based upon the total of the balance sheet, their percentages vary. The percentage of share capital was 45% of the total liabilities in 2018 and 40% of the total liabilities in 2019. So the proportion of share capital of Cambridge Limited reduced from 2018 to 2019. That is the first conclusion regarding share capital. Then coming to reserves and surplus, in 2018, the firm had only 10% of reserves and surplus with them. But when it came to 2019, the reserves and surplus, the reserves kept by the company, Cambridge Limited, increased by 2%. Regarding the non-current liabilities, there is a decrease of just 3% from 2018 to 2019. And regarding the current liabilities, there is a huge increase from 10% to 16%. So it is clear from this analysis that the non-current liabilities got reduced over time and the current liabilities was increased over time. So please remember which all are the current liabilities that would appear in the balance sheet of a company. Okay, so that is regarding the equity and liability. And coming to the asset part, we can conclude that there is a slight decrease from 70% in 2018 to 68% in 2019. And in the same manner, there is a slight increase of 2% by comparing 2018 and 2019 in the case of current assets. So 70% of the total asset forms the non-current assets in 2018, and 68% of the total assets comprises of non-current asset in 2019. So this company keeps only limited current asset. So that we can conclude that the working capital is very less in the case of Cambridge Limited. So this is the analysis and interpretation regarding common sales balance sheet. In the next video, we will discuss about the common sales statement of profit and loss, and we will interpret the same. Thank you.